show you. I love how the bottom of the bag extends like this. I love the shape of this bag. The skirt off on top does that. I'm looking into better equipment to hold my camera in place up above. But in the meantime, we're gonna have to deal with this setup. So this bag has this really intricate print. I guess you would call this detail, not print. Even though I'm sure it's, pressed and printed somewhere. But it has these two wobbles for closure. And inside you have just like any rack with one single pocket. It's a cute, simple bag, but it's not meant to be like a dressy bag. I would just say this is your, in the middle kind of bag. So, this bag is not supposed to be dressy. I would say it's more moderate. Same print on both sides. The bottom is a little bit wider, maybe 2 inches. But I love the simplicity of this bag. I love how simple it is. I love its diversity. You can carry this with wearing jeans. You can carry this if you're wearing a summer dress. Wear this if you're wearing a dressy suit, like a pantsuit. So here's item one. The second one. Blue bag. I need to have these brushed. But this blue bag is on the back. It's like this PVC. Like, I don't know. Is this leather? I don't know what they call it. Here you see the difference, like leather and chamois and suede. Inside the option of a chain link strap, and this is an Italian brand named Aldo. I love this blue color on the inside with one single pocket. This bag, it's a little bit more daring. It's not a wallet. It is a bag, but there's something a little bit more chic, more artsy about it. It's about the same length as the other one. Okay, this bag put in the pile just to show it to you. It's not necessarily a bag that I carry with me on a regular basis. This is more my work bag. So it might look a little bit strange, but it has these straps. This one of those that you put on your waist and your thigh, and you hold your tools in it or whatever you need to hold in it. In my case, I would put this around my waist, and then I tucked it in here. I didn't open it beforehand, but in my case, I use this on set, because sometimes your hands are not free. And this is, by the way, I've done acting, but I also work on set. I majored in filmmaking. So, if I'm working on set, my hands are usually full. I don't have room. Sometimes I'm wearing, skinny jeans that have tiny pockets, and I need a room for my phone, things that I want with me. So I like this bag. Well, I purchased this bag for that purpose. I'm not sure it actually fit what I, all the criteria that I wanted it for. First of all, it ended up being a little way too bulky. But I mean, if I was called on set tomorrow, I would still take it, because I need a place for a radio, and the radio's usually... Well, this is a good size for the radio, so you stick the radio in here, but you can't close this because the radio has an antenna that sticks out, so I usually put it, here on the side. Or I could just stick out the antenna, and then I'll put my cell phone in there too, and then whatever else I happen to be carrying. Sometimes I'll have my chapstick with me. If we're working outside, we're filming outside, I'll have a bottle of water. Because there's water all over the place on set, but sometimes you're out there and you want to carry your own bottle, I'll have a bottle of water. If not, I'll have my cap strapped on here, for indoor, outdoor. If I go outside, I wear my cap. So yeah, it just has a bunch of little pockets. They're all empty. I empty them right after and store them away. There's a cute little pocket up here. This is perfect for sunglasses. Sunglasses in there, because sometimes you'll be in and sometimes you'll be called to run outside. And by the way, if you are in the industry, you know how hectic it could be. I mean, you're inside, you're outside, you're running up and down, and all over the place. It is so easy to be an actress. So easy. It's like a different ball game. You're treated a little differently too. I mean, that's just Hollywood. But when you're in the industry running a set, it is such a high stress environment. Very professional, very fast paced, and you better know what you're doing. Okay, so there's also a big zipper. I don't think I've ever used this zipper. That's funny. I did not realize that I had a zipper back here. That's funny. Okay, so there's one big that I could also utilize. I don't know how to ever use it. When you're on set, you carry so little anyway. It's not like you're going to carry your blush and makeup, guys. You're on set. You don't have time for that. Put on your sunblock, you do what you do beforehand, and your deodorant beforehand, because when you're on set, you're not going to have the luxuries of that. You're supposed to be invisible, just doing your job behind the scenes. Okay, so in here we've got an additional two pockets. This is where I have the strap that goes around the thigh. I just kind of tucked it in there. So then, oh, something else in here too. Okay, so what I found was this visitor pass, and you can see it says CBS Studio Center, CBS Studio Center. I can't show you the project or anything like that. Find a sleeker, less bulky bag, I will definitely get you can imagine, once you put a radio in here, and a bottle of water, your cell phone, this thing is sticking out like 4 or 5 inches on your thigh, so, I don't know, but everybody's carrying one of these, on set, if you're working on set. And another thing, everybody's got a backpack. Everybody's usually, instead of getting like a purse, you would just get like a backpack where you put what you think you'll need, like a sweatshirt, if it's going to be cold outside, whatever else it is. Even, you're always carrying a backpack. The back side of this has some stretchy material. Oh, it makes a nice sound, does it not? So, yeah, that's that. I like the color. Very army greenish. Yeah. Or maybe it's not army green. Wait a second. It's like brown. Yeah. On to the next part. Item. Okay, the next one is already got a few things in here. Do you ever switch wallets from one to the other and you realize you've always find a purse or a bag that has remnants of last time you used it? It's almost like little time capsules. Anyway, this one has a cute little handle on the side, and I like that it's on the side here. It's more secure. I used to have it where the handle was on here. And if I carried the purse on this side, you always have to carry it this way, by accident. I mean, I would just pick it up, when I'm rushing in. And this would just, slide open. The zipper was much smoother, too, to top it off. And because of the weight of the wallet, if you're carrying it, handle on here, it would just, slowly unzip and spill everything out. It actually happened to me 2 times. Now, I also have another one where the hook goes on here and on here. That's kind of overkill. Where, you'll open it and, one handle's still here, the other's stretched. I don't like those either. I just like this. It's quite long enough for me to, put it in my wrist and still be able to carry it. I don't just put it on my wrist and let it dangle and swing. Put it on my wrist and I'll still be holding it. And the nice thing about this little bag is I don't call them wallets. I do not carry purses. If I did, I would forget it at a restaurant or wherever I went because I'm so not used to carrying a purse ever. In fact, I once wanted to carry a purse. I put my things in there. And then after leaving the restaurant and driving away, I was like, oh my god, where's my phone? Oh, it's in that thing. So, yeah, ended up going back and it was really scary. And so I just don't bother anymore. I like to carry that. Plus, there's nothing to put in a purse. What the hell are you supposed to put in it? It's not baggage. You're not traveling. So only thing I ever need is my debit card and or store card and my cell phone. That's it. That's it. Nothing else. I don't need a brush. I don't need makeup products. I don't need any of that with me. So yeah, that's the reason these are, like, I call these, like, my bags. Like, this would be perfect. It's a wristlet or a wallet. I don't know what you call it, but this is good enough. Serves the purpose well. And inside this one is something very unique. You'll find a little battery pack. This is an actual battery pack that you can charge. And it's got different connectors for different types of media. In my case, there's one for the iPhone. I have an iPhone X for now. It actually needs charging. Okay, let's move on. Now these are some worn out little wristlets that I plan on getting rid of. They're so old and tattered. So this one is a cute little owl. I got this from Target, I think, at the time, and I love the vibrant colors, and there is a cute little handle. It's a little bit shorter than the other one, but that's not a bad thing. I love the size of this one. The sheer size is perfect. Perfect for a cell phone. I don't know if it'll actually fit iPhone X. Maybe if it wasn't in an otter box. And it's got a cute little handle here for opening the zipper. Inside there's room for credit cards, ID, whatever, and the phone. It's funny because when I'm looking for these, I will always put my phone up against it. See, like, yeah, he's got a cute little heart, stitched, cute little feet, little green wings, tiny little ears. Look at that beak. She's not so cute. But anyway, this has been kind of scuffed up, and the back is really tattered up. Let's see. There's another pocket here. And the edges. So I'll be tossing this as soon as the video is over. This video may end up being in two parts. Okay, so this is one small bag. It's all sequins. It's almost shaped like a heart. It's really adorable. And the handles are shorter. I like that because I never need to put a bag on my shoulder. Now, I have a bag that, which I'll need to find, it kind of like goes across the chest. And those, like when you're going to Disney, I'll have something like that. But this little one here is, it's got like this cute little bow tie. They lift. And this little bag, honestly, I would wear it any day. I would hold it and carry it any day. It's so small, so cute. Doesn't need to be, you don't need formalities for a date, whatever. It's not a fancy bag. I wouldn't call it a fancy bag. I'll call it more of